We're in Bloomsbury, it's in Holborn. We're at an auction house. It's 1999, so it's the turn of the millennium. And we are at the beginning of the hottest, most glorious summer that London has known for many years. And in the middle of an argument about a beautiful young woman who has come back from New York without any warning at all. I had the idea that Kate would go to the Victoria Albert Museum, she would be archiving its collection, and she would discover a clue about the missing debutante, and then all of the clues would be found in the collection itself. So I had this really grandiose idea, and I was very excited about it, and I began to write this book, and before I knew it, I was swimming in extra characters. This mystery, this kind of thrilling psychological romantic tale, instead of being lean and fast-paced, was huge and cumbersome and, you know, overladen with descriptive passages. So I was moaning to a fellow writer of mine named Annabelle Giles, and I was saying, I can't control this book, it's gotten so heavy, I don't know what to do. And she said to me, you don't need a museum, you simply need to cut it right down, Kathleen, you need a shoebox. So, completely intrigued, I met her and she handed me this shoebox that she had had for many years, and it was from the late 1920s, early 1930s, and she had tied it up with a little salmon ribbon, and she said, you're not allowed even to look into the shoebox until you reach the point in the book where your character discovers it. So what we've got is we've got a beautiful summer. We've got a crumbling Georgian mansion by the sea. We've got two strangers who are attracted to each other, wandering around this house, valuing its contents. And we've got a locked room in the far wing. Kate, our main character, finds the locked room, unlocks the door. It's a beautiful room, covered in gilt, the most beautiful room in the house, in fact. And it's bare except for some bookshelves and a single bed. And behind some of the books on the bookshelves, she finds a shoebox. And she becomes obsessed with the objects in the shoebox. Because the one thing that everyone knows about Ensley House is it was the home of the Blythe sisters, who were the most beautiful debutantes between the wars. Until one of them, Baby Blythe, the most dangerous and sexy of the two, went missing.